So you've probably seen the label that says non-GMO or non-GMO project verified. What does that mean and is it good for diabetics? Hi everyone, my name is James Marin. I'm a holistic registered dietitian, environmental nutritionist, author, speaker, and diabetes expert. Welcome back to another video. Thanks for joining us. If you're new, my name is James. I have my own private practice where I help my patients beat their diabetes amongst other diseases, and I use that with nutrition and food and lifestyle medicine. Okay, so today we're gonna be talking about non-GMO. What does that mean? Okay, so I'm gonna do a whole other video on what is non-GMO or what is a GM or GMO, okay? But today we're gonna be talking about the non-GMO seal, right? So you're seeing that on a lot of food packaging. You're seeing that on the front of the package where it says non-GMO, non-GMO project verified. Today we're gonna discuss if that's good for diabetics, okay? So again, non-GMO, we'll get into that very quickly, but again, I'll make another video where I get into it in a lot more detail. Non-GMO, so genetically modified organism is what GMO stands for. This seal provides companies a way to verify that less than 0.9% of their product has GMOs, okay? So again, 99.9% of their product has no GMOs, okay? So again, so a huge amount of their product does not contain GMOs, genetically modified organisms, okay? Why is this important? Well, for diabetics, I would say non-GMO is good to buy, okay? It's okay because you're gonna get less genetically modified organisms. Why that is important is because GM crops, corn, soybean, canola, alfalfa are some of the biggest genetically modified crops, and GM crops are sprayed more with pesticides. That is why for a majority of these crops and plants, they are genetically modified. They're genetically modified to withstand the pesticide. So farmers usually spray more of this pesticide on the crop to kill other bugs or weeds or everything else except the plant. That means though, these genetically modified foods then will contain more of the pesticide residue, and you are exposed to more of this pesticide residue. That is not good if you're diabetic or you're at risk for diabetes, because these pesticides are endocrine disruptors amongst other things, and they are going to directly affect your pancreas and your GI health and you name it, okay? So it's not good. So if you can buy non-GMO or non-GMO project verified, that is great. I did another video on if diabetics should buy organic, so you should definitely check that video out. I highly recommend, if you had a choice, buy certified organic. That is gonna be way more important than non-GMO. But again, both are great. Both are good for diabetics. Certified organic is gonna be a lot better, and you could find out why in the other video I did on if diabetics should buy organic. But hopefully you have a better understanding of what GMO is or GM crops and why you should buy non-GMO food items whenever possible. And if all your food can be non-GMO, that would be great, okay? So again, share this with friends and family, share this with anyone you know interested in learning more about GMO or buying non-GMO, and give us a like. Click in the description below is a link where you can get more information on what foods to avoid, what foods to buy, how to go shopping, how to meal plan. So it's all there for you. Click the link below, learn more, and as always, have a wonderful day.